And maybe I mentioned this in the first lecture, but he's talking about this and I tried to get the rights to reproduce it. It turned out that she must have been a successful person. And so she got all her mother to the NAACP. Introduced to L. Ron Hubbard by John, when I was an undergraduate, John Campbell was the great editor of the what a marvelous title. And this fairly mediocre science fiction writer, L. Ron Hubbard, invented a new Dianetics. I'll tell you that story another time. But John Campbell, every year I invite a bunch of stories. I wanted other people, but anyway, I did. Influence on me from actually early years, but standard explanation is the rise of the religions and wanting to come back. And you see, with the first signs of anything like modern science, at least in my view, with Galileo and Newton, a couple of people before that, there are some people in the Muslim world. Who invented some high school algebra, and they make a big fuss about that. It looks like Archimedes, in very recently discovered manuscripts, computed an integer. He found the volume in the column, which is, what is it? There isn't much psychology in the modern sense. Because when I look at the history that I encountered about psychology, there are many things that I understand among the best. And as far as I can see, there were no psychologists really as good as that. What we have of Aristotle is a lot of writing, but it's all cobbled together by students from all sorts of manuscripts by other people who took notes, and Aristotle claims to have learned a lot from Plato. Centuries before the Christian era, and then a couple of thousand years later, we start to find people like Spinoza. And John Locke and David Hume, who start to make psychology theories. Now, is one of the reasons why we think that the physical world and lots of other kinds of world, each of us has some imaginary mind. What they are, the philosophers talk about it as well, so there are lots of problems about ourselves. And
thank you.
This is simply a sign. If you do it with one example, if you're smart enough to idea. Now, when I say salient idea, I don't mean important. What I mean is an idea that sticks out. Some theses, funnily enough, have too many good ideas, and what that's all about, because which one is it? So you need an idea that sticks out. So the idea that sticks out here was a notion of a near miss. You see, this is something else, but it doesn't miss by much. So it's in the news. And finally, you can tell me. But they're very good for making However, his projects. Disappeared without a trace. That theory was so wrong that it got a national and it corrupted AI research in Japan for several years. I thought this became popular because he said maybe the important things about thinking is that there's no internal representation. You're just reacting to situations. And you have a big library of how to react to each situation. So, for hundreds of years, and it opened the door. So far, no robot can open the door.
Provided under a Creative Commons license. Your support will help you to education resources for free. To make a donation or get additional materials from hundreds of MIT courses, visit MIT Open Classroom at ocw.mit.edu.
Bisa begitu.
Connected to a little infirmity, three or four states. Then, you have more sensory systems to the outer world, and you get to get more to the real world.
Yeah, kena juga.
There's a little structure that's somewhat like that, which is used by the frontal part of the cortex to make very abstract ideas. You understand? The more abstract the idea, the simpler and more structured the language is. Abstract is the main part. Abstract means stupid. Real things are infinitely complicated. And here's a certain input that means if you're in that state, and if you pop that input again, it does this. And if you say, it goes. So if three of them get you back to the end, but if I go this, this, and that, that would mean to go like this, this, and that. So this would be, that means, that's a different. But the idea, in other words, magnitude is a little more than which is very small and only has 3 steps. And you have actions that you can perform on it. And you have an exit card, which is the best of the steps. Once it gets done, then you could learn by experience that if you go left, right, left, you're back where you are. And if you go left, right, you're back where you are. And if you go left, right, that's like going one left.
Yeah.
La.
Thank you. sweet move. And you'll have to go to hell if you conclude your talk by saying thank you, but you just want it. When you say thank you, and you want to thank you for listening, it's a difficult to stay that long out of the pool. And they had a profound desire to be somewhere else.
Oh, no.
So what's the bottom of the clause as far as you can mouth a thank you? That's not thank you. Now you say to me, well, doesn't everybody say thank you? What everybody does is not necessarily do that. And I like to look at some talks again without saying thank you. Yes, here are the things that I typically demonstrate. This is what we do. So, example, introduce yourself. What about the other part? You know, you get your final slide up there as a contribution slide. Sometimes you have to tell people you're finished. So, that's what you do in the final words. It's okay. When it comes to the voice, you can change your voice parameters, your voice energy. I'm sitting in another bar this morning, Texas. It's fine as an opportunity to tell people who you are. It's just. What about this one? I often see it. I never see anybody running down. Also, oh my God. All of these lines do nothing for you. To lead people to what you, to who you are. So what about this? This is another one? It might seem so at first, but here's the problem. Conclusions, these are just the conclusions. What they care about is what you need to know the final words. Some examples of possibilities. How about this one? Well, you might see this side. And think to yourself, there are 1,000 faculty at MIT. But it's only a tiny piece of work if you divide by 1,000. So you show a whole gigantic list of collaborators at the end of the conference. It's kind of left out because it suggests that nobody knew did you do anything significant. Now again, you don't have any collaborators, right? So what did you do that? On the first slide. All this was on the first slide. These are the collaborators. One of the things you need to do is to make sure that you have some kind of symbol associated with your work. So this art example is actually from a lot of years ago. In the course of my work at that time, this actually became mildly famous, and I didn't know why. It was only many years later that I realized that I was the only one. The first one was the arch. It's the arch itself. The kind of phrase that provides a handle on the work. In this case, the phrase was, there was one shot because it came out of the work, but it's something definite from every example that was presented to us. So we're going from the this configuration to something that isn't in our space for that configuration.